What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here for the reading of the next Bitcoin Optech newsletter. Thank you very much for the entire team here, and let's get into the reading of newsletter number one on June 26, 2018. Welcome to the first Bitcoin Optech Group newsletter. As a member of our new organization, you can expect to see regular newsletters from us covering Bitcoin open source development and protocol news, Optech announcement, and member companies case study. We anticipate publishing these newsletters on our website. We hope you find these newsletters of value, and we're creating this for you, so please feel free feel comfortable reaching out to us if you have feedback. Be it additional things you'd like to see us cover or improvements to what we are already including. A reminder to companies that haven't yet become an official member yet, we ask you to pay a nominal contribution of $5,000 to help fund our expenses. The first Optech workshop. The Bitcoin Optech Group is organizing the first of a series of workshops to be held on July 17th in San Francisco. Square has graciously offered to host the afternoon workshop, and we will have a group dinner afterwards. Participants will be 1 to 2 engineers from the San Francisco Bay Area of Bitcoin companies. We will have roundtable discussions covering 3 topics: coin selection best practices, fee estimation, replaced by fee, child pays for parent best practices, the Optech community and communications, and optimizing Optech for business needs. We plan to organize similar workshops in other regions based on Optech member company demand. If this sounds appealing to you, please feel free to reach out to us and let us know what you'd like to see. Open source news. A consistent theme we have heard from our initial outreach to the Bitcoin companies is the desire to improve communication with the open source community. To that end, in each newsletter, we plan to provide a summary of relevant action items, dashboard items, and news from the broader Bitcoin open source community. Action items. A pending denial of service vulnerability disclosed for Bitcoin Core version 0.12 and earlier. Altcoins may be affected. They mean shitcoins. As announced in November 2016, Bitcoin Core developers are planning to release the private key Satoshi Nakamoto created in 2010 to sign network alerts. This key can be abused to create an out-of-memory condition for Bitcoin version 0.3.9 through Bitcoin Core version 0.12 that will result in those nodes crashing. But there are no disclosed money-losing attacks. Many altcoins have forked before code prior to version 0.12 and may be vulnerable to the same attacks, but they have used different keys, and so the attack cannot be exploited unless those keys are also misused. Recommended actions are, first, checking your infrastructure for Bitcoin nodes version 0.12 or below and upgrading them if possible. This includes older versions of Bitcoin XT, Bitcoin Classic, and Bitcoin Unlimited. Second, checking your infrastructure for altcoin nodes based on Bitcoin Core 0.12 or below, either upgrading them or putting them behind a proxy that filters out peer-to-peer protocol alert messages. If you are absolutely reliant upon pre-version 0.12 nodes, please inform a Bitcoin Core developer or our Optech contact immediately. Bitcoin Core version 16.1 is released, containing a fix for a case that could cause a monetary loss for miners in situations expected to be quite rare. Also fixes a denial of service attack that mostly affected new nodes and includes a change to relay policy in advance for a possible future soft fork more than a year from now. Upgrading is recommended for all users and highly recommended for miners. the Bitcoin Developer mailing list is changing hosts. If you subscribe to the public Bitcoin Development mailing list, which you should, note that an announcement will soon be posted about a change of domain name. It's not known yet if any user action will be required besides addressing emails to a different domain name, although a change of host 3 years ago required all members to resubscribe. Dashboard items. Transaction fees are increasing. A spike in transaction fees seen earlier last week was believed to have been related to BitHump hack. Both the attacker moving the stolen funds and other people moving their funds in response to rapid changing exchange fees. As of this email, low fee transactions are still confirming within a few blocks, making it good time for consolidation transactions. News. New backup and recovery format for private key material. Several developers are working on a new encoding of Bitcoin private keys, hierarchical deterministic wallet extended public and private keys, and hierarchical deterministic wallet seeds. This format is loosely based upon the BEC32 format used for native SegWit addresses. The encoding is being actively developed on the Bitcoin Dev mailing list, and participants is encouraged for any company that handles private key materials in your own backups, for example, paper wallet backups, or provide such services to customers, for example, fund sweeping. Coin selection simulations. The upcoming version 0.17 release of Bitcoin Core implements a much more effective coin selection algorithm based on Mark Earhart's branch and bound algorithm. Contributors are currently running simulations aimed at identifying a suitable fallback strategy for when that ideal strategy does not work. If your organization uses Bitcoin Core to optimize coin selection for minimizing fees, it may be worthwhile to monitor or contribute to Bitcoin Core pull requests. BIP 174 discussion. Mailing list discussion continues surrounding the proposed BIP for an industry standard to make it easier for wallets to communicate with each other in the case of online, offline, hot-cold wallets, software-hardware wallets, and multi-sig wallets. However, significant changes to the proposal are now being resisted, so finalization may be near. If your organization produces or makes critical use of one of the aforementioned interoperable wallets, you may wish to evaluate the current proposal as soon as possible before it is finalized. Dynamic wallet loading in Bitcoin Core. The last pull request has been merged for a new set of RPCs in Bitcoin Core designed to allow it to dynamically create new wallets in multi-wallet mode. Load them and unload them. If your organization manages transactions from within Bitcoin Core or wants to do that, this can make it significantly easier to segment your wallet. For example, separating customer deposits from company funds or hot wallet funds from watch-only cold wallet funds. Pre-production code is available on the Bitcoin Core master Git branch using the RPC create wallet, load wallet, and unload wallet. Please subscribe to the newsletter of the Bitcoin Operations Technology Company. And again, I want to thank these individuals wholeheartedly for producing the, in my opinion, by far best and most technical but still accessible newsletter in Bitcoin. Pierce, as always, it's been a pleasure talking to you, and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.